한 금방 이제 들어가요. 네. 네, 들어왔습니다. Hello.
Hello.
제 목소리 잘 들리시나요?
네, 잘 들려요.
오케이. 자, so hi everyone. So we have Miss Jisoo joining us for day two. So today she is going to show us live drawing today, and then we have an artist Bowen doing a live as a live interpreter today, and we have Hyunjin in the background. Who will be helping us throughout the live drawing with Miss Jisoo and various artists coming up. So, okay. So, if Miss Jisoo's ready, please say
네,
hi to
준비됐습니다.
fans. Okay, 인사 한번
안녕하세요.
해주세요.
Hello, everyone.
오늘 손이 꽁꽁 얼었어요.
Miss Jisoo's hands are all frozen, so she is going to have to warm them up.
아, 진짜 겨울왕국입니다. 하얘요. 차가 안
It's
열렸어요.
a frozen season in South Korea today.
자, 뭐 그림은 그릴 수 있을 것 같아요.
But at the same time, she will be able to draw.
Great. So 그러면은 이거 밑에 한번 보여 카메라 바꿔 주시고요. So we're gonna get started.
그림 사이즈는 그냥 A4 종이.
So she brought a A4 size paper today.
근데 얇은 A4 종이는 아니고요.
That's not just the normal A4.
사실 저는 그냥 얇은 A4 종이에 그리는 걸 좋아하긴 하는데,
She prefers to draw on a normal A4 size paper, but this time,
그릴 때는 얇은 종이가 좋은데 보관하기에는 두꺼운 종이가 좋겠죠.
but to when she draws, she prefers a normal A4 size paper, but for a reason to preserve the drawing properly, she would recommend something more thick.
저는 그냥 간단한 거 그릴 거예요. 그 30분밖에 시간도 없고.
So she has 30 minutes to perform a live drawing show today. So she is going to draw something simple, pretty much simple today.
이렇게
So she is going to start now.
재료는 제가 늘 쓰는 것처럼 그냥 투펜.
So the medium that she will be using today, is the medium that she uses all the time, brush pens.
커미션 주문한 분들도 있으셨는데, 그거는 오늘 저녁부터 그릴 거고요. 제가 뭐 그림은 항상 영상 찍으니까요. 영상도 나중에 볼수 있을 거예요.
And she has received all the requirements for the commissions, and she is going to start working on that tonight. And since she films all her procedures when she draws, so you guys who asked Ms. Jesus for commissions will be able to find the video footage later on.
학대도 되나요,
네,
선생님?
지금
네, 있습니다.
이거 질문을 읽어도 될까요?
네.
Will Jisoo ever take male commissions? 남자 커미션도 받으시나요?
네, 할 수는 있는데,
Yes, she is. She is capable of doing it.
제 강점은 아니기 때문에.
But it's not one of her strongest points. So she would recommend something more girly.
전에는 사람이 아닌 커미션도 몇 개 왔었어요.
사람 아닌 거요?
네.
There has been people who ask for commissions that are not human too.
예를 들면 포켓몬.
For example, Pokemon.
그리고 뭐지? 기계 같은 거 뭐 이런 거.
Mechanics.
힘들었어요.
It was Jisoo went through a tough time drawing all that.
아, 공부를 많이 해야겠다.
She was motivated to study more.
근데 가끔 그런 생각도 하거든요. 뭐 제가 못 그리는 것도 많이 연습을 해야겠지만 그 남들이 보고 싶어 하는 걸 보여주는 것도 필요한 것 같아서.
So what she thought after receiving those kinds of requirements, she realized that it is important to practice what you're not good at or used to drawing. At the same time, she thought that she realized that it is also important to let people see what they want to see in an artist.
오늘 이따가 그 아트잼 있잖아요.
네.
그때는 아마 여자를 안 그릴 것 같아요.
Oh. And so later on, as you guys know already, there is another art jam. Scheduled. And Miss Jisoo is not going to draw any girls for the art gym later on. And there is Hyunjin who is very disappointed at the back. She's going very, very slow because her hand is freezing right now. She just arrived at the studio, so her hand is a little bit frozen.
여러분 진짜 깜짝 놀랐어요. 창문이 얼어 있었어요. 창문이.
It's very, very cool today in South Korea. I think it's around -9, -10 degrees. And when she woke up today morning, she was really surprised because the window was frozen.
차의 창문이 안 열렸어.
She couldn't open the window on her car because the window was frozen. 미스 지수 is beautiful.
아닙니다.
She said no.
그 얘기 하지 마세요. 현지 쌤이 뒤에서 비 오세요.
아니야, 나도 그랬습니다.
Today it's -11 degrees in Paju, South Korea.
서울보다 많이 추워요.
Paju is on the north side of South Korea, so it's colder than in Seoul. So that's why Ms. Jisoo's hand is a little bit frozen, and that's why she's going a little bit slow today. If you guys have any questions, Ms. Jisoo will be able to answer your questions while she draws, so please don't hesitate. 선미님이 지수 선생님은 김정기 쌤한테 언제부터 배우셨어요?
진짜 제 나이를 생각하면
Sunmin asked Miss Jisoo since when she started learning from Kim Jong-gi and Jisoo said from very very long time ago.
고등학교 3학년 겨울방학 때부터요.
So she started to learn from Kim Jong-gi from the winter vacation on her third year of high school.
몇 년도인지 말할 수 없습니다.
And she won't give you guys the year. The number of the year. Do you ever do underlying sketches for certain commissions, like things out of your comfort zone? Underlying sketches, do you mean like pencil sketches before she starts inking? 선미님이 대답 감사합니다. 3학년입니다. How much does it cost, the commission? Normally,
besides A4 size 같은 경우에는 220불인데 이거보다는 조금 더 정성이 많이 들어가 있다.
이거보다는 정성이 많이 들어간다. So, the cost of her commission starts from $220. So with this size, but of course she's going to put much more effort into it. This is just the
심플 스케치고 절반은 절반.
So half the size of A4, the cost of the commission would be $110. So yes, this is just a basic line drawing. So this is not the kind of thing that Jisoo will do for a commission.
좀 커미션 할 때는 시작은 이렇게까지 심각하게 많이 하려고 생각 안 했는데 하다 보니까 막 재밌어서 제가 막 시간 엄청 늘어서.
At first, when she started to work on commissions, she was very at ease at first. But as the time passes, she found it more amusing to work on commissions. So she put a lot of effort into it. She does a lot of research for reference images. So if you guys are interested, don't hesitate to ask her, command her some commissions.
그리고 그 보인 씨랑 제가 말할 때 조금 멍해 보인다고 생각이 드시겠는데 이게 소리가 두 번 올려서 그러니까 이해해 주세요. 우리 귀 속에서 두 번씩 들려요.
And you guys might think that Miss Jisoo is a bit how do I say that?
보인 씨도
numb 좀 뺐어요.
아 그래요?
a little bit numb today, but it's because she has a earpod inside her ear to listen to communicate in long distance. But since we have like several audios, she's listening. The sound is echoing too much, so that's why she's a bit slow when responding to the question. I got a commission from Miss Jisoo recently, and it is awesome. I definitely recommend getting one. Jisoo 씨한테
감사합니다.
Thank you very much. Roko Costello, you made it possible for Miss Jisoo to buy to eat some good snacks.
Pizza 사 먹었네요.
Please let Miss Jisoo know that I received my commission of a girl in stockings recently, and I love it. 커미션 이분이 요청하신 거는 스타킹 신고 있는 여자였는데 너무 좋다고 합니다.
네네네.
Yes,
신하시겠다. 그거는 아직 아마 공개를 안 한 걸로 알고 있어요.
네?
아직 제가 공개를 안 한.
It's one of the commissions that she hasn't revealed yet. So, okay. How did you develop your current style of drawing the female head? I really admire her faces and would like to know how I could do something similar.
어떻게 지수 씨가 지금 이제 그리는 얼굴 스타일 그림을 발전시키게 되었는지 너무 좋대요, 그림이. 아, 감사합니다. 질문은 아니죠?
어떻게 발전시켰는지가?
제가 좋아하는 많은 작가들의 영향과 제가 좋아하는 뭐 연예인들 합쳐진 것 같아요.
So how did Miss Jisoo develop her current style of drawing the female head? Jisoo said that it's a combination of all the drawing styles that she admired since she was little, and she is also inspired by all the singers, famous people, stars that she likes, faces of the stars that she likes. Has Jisoo always done artful work, or has she ever had a regular job?
항상 미술을 직업으로 가지셨는지 아니면 그냥 일반적인 직장도 다녀보신 적 있는지? 저는 좀 다른 일을 한 번도 안 해본 것 같아요.
No, she never had the regular job, if I may, but she always worked in art.
항상 그림을 배우거나 그림 선생님을 하거나
Every job that she had was related to art. So she used to teach, or she did illustrations, she did freelancing.
딱 하나 상관없는 일이라고 하면은 미술 학원에서 격리 같은 걸 한 거.
If she has to name one irregular job, if I may, that she did was to work as a accountancy in a art school.
그것도 현진쌤 학원이니까 뭐.
And then art school was Supranny, Hyunjin's art school, so it was all related to art.
계산하느라고.
She had to calculate things. Yes, I was thinking if she ever did underlying pencil sketches for certain commissions, or does she always go straight into ink? 커미션 하실 때 스케치도 하시고 하신다면 잉크로 바로 들어가시는지?
잉크로 바로 들어가요.
She goes straight into ink.
근데 어제 보여준 것처럼 연습장에 그 아이디어 스케치를 하고 그걸 보고 그냥.
So, but like as she showed you guys yesterday, her sketchbook, she does a she does various sketches before actually working on a commission. So she does lots and lots of sketches, pencil sketches on her sketchbook to search the correct drawing for her commission, and then she would go straight into ink. So she's going to add some more colors onto the line artwork.
소리가 길어졌네. 보완해 보겠습니다.
She has a little bit a she has a little bit she has a waist a little bit long, so she's going to correct that. 보고. Did you do a lot of time to figure drawings? 그 시간 제한 있는 누도 그렇게 많이 하셨나요?
시간 제한.
네, 그냥 뭐 3분, 5분 뭐 이렇게.
네. 예전에 인체 공부 열심히 할 때 누드 크로키 할 때 뭐 30초짜리 뭐 5분짜리 이렇게 계속 돌아가면서 재밌어요. 진짜 재밌어요.
Yes, she did. She did a lot of figure drawings when she was really into studying anatomy. So she did a lot and lots of figure drawings of 30 seconds, 5 minutes. Things like that, and she says that it's super interesting.
그때 그렸던 그림들이 거의 다 헐벗고 있거든요.
And at that time, when she was doing a lot of figure drawings, all her drawings, all the things that she draws are naked.
그게 미스디즈 1번 책에.
And all those drawings are in the book Miss Jisoo Volume 1.
아마 옷 그리는 방법을 몰라서 그랬던 거.
And she thinks that it's because she wasn't so into drawing clothes. Question, how did you start working with Super Annie? Did you ask you wanted to join or were you hunted by Hyunjin?
현진쌤이 낚아갔나요?
She was hunted by Hyunjin, maybe?
Maybe.
Hunted.
진짜 우리 그 농담 많이 하는데 맨헌트라고 현진쌤 아트 페어 같은데 가면은
맞아
네, 만나자마자 좋으면 데려오는 게 아니라 몇 년 동안 이렇게 지그시 보면서 저 사람 괜찮다 이러면은 맨헌트 해오잖아요.
Miss Jesus says that they joke a lot inside in Super Annie. When Hyunjin likes a certain person, a certain artist, he would not just go straight and recruit them. But he would like eye on the artist for, you know, a couple of years and like saying, I like him, I like that artist. And then he would manhunt him.
밥을 사주고.
Oh, girl.
술을 사주고.
Hyunjin would buy, Hyunjin would like pay for foods, pay for drinks. He would like eye on that person, eye on that artist. And then finally, he would he would fish for the artist.
Manhunt.
역시 현진쌤 재능 컬렉터.
재능 컬렉터.
'How often does she get commissions that's not girls?' 여자가 아닌 커미션 얼마나 많이 받으시는지.
가격은 같아요.
네?
가격은
같아요. 그러니까 여자가 아닌 커미션도 가끔 받기는 하시는지 자주 받으시는지.
아니요, 정말 거의.
It's very rare.
왜냐하면 다들 아니까.
Because everyone knows what she's like to draw. Um, Miss Jisoo probably answered it sometime already. But how can you prefer drawing only female characters? 물론 이제 답을 하셨을 것 같긴 하지만 어떻게 네. 여자 캐릭터만 그리게 되셨는지.
좋아하는 것만 먹는 사람이 있는 것처럼 좋아하는 것만 그리는 사람.
She would put it like as if you know there are people who only eat what they like to eat. It's the same for Miss Jisoo. She likes she draws what she likes to draw.
편집합니다.
응?
편집.
She's a yeah. She's picky. She is not picky. She eats only one. She eats only what she wants. About her process of learning to draw the figure, did she draw quirky or gestural drawings? 사람 그림 연습하실 때요, 크로키를 하셨는지 아니면 이제 제스처 드로잉을 하셨는지.
아, 그거는 아까 말한 것처럼 옛날에 많이 했고 요즘은 거의 안 하는 거.
둘 다 하신 거죠?
네, 네, 네.
She did both. She drew quirky and gestural drawings a lot before.
그때는 진짜 아무것도 생각 안 하고 인체에만 딱 집중해서 그랬던 거.
And at that time, she thought about nothing else but just the anatomy, human anatomy.
왜냐면 그때가 막 인체를 현진쌤한테 배웠을 때라서 근육 이름을 아니까 너무 재밌어서 그랬던 것 같아요.
Because at that moment, she was learning anatomy from Hyunjin Kim, and she found it really amusing to understand all the names and structures of a human body, the muscles of the muscles and bones. So. Does Miss Jisoo prefer to be told exactly what to do for a commission or the freedom to do what she wants? 커미션에서 정확히 어떤 그림을 그리라고 요청을 들어온 게 나은지 아니면 자유도가 있는 게 나은지?
저는 사실 자유도 있는 게 좋은데 거의 대부분 원하는 걸 말을 해주세요.
If she has to choose one, she would prefer freedom. But most of the time, people ask her exactly what they want for a commission and she's okay with it.
사실 특정 캐릭터를 정해주는 것보다는 어떤 타입을 원한다 해주는 게 제일 좋아요.
But the best option, the best choice would be, wouldn't be asking her to draw this character, but to explain her what kind of character that you would like.
왜냐면 캐릭터를 정해주시면은 약간 기존에 있는 캐릭터를 그려야 되는 그 부담감.
She's a bit if when she is asked to draw a certain character, she's a bit you know stressed out because she has to describe perfectly the character. Has Kim Jong-gi ever commissioned her? If yes, what was it?
정기쌤이 커미션을 하신 적이 있는지. 정기쌤이 커미션을 뭐?
지수 씨한테. 커미션 이렇게 뭐 그려달라고 부탁한 적 있는지 있으면 무엇이었는지
그런 건 없는데 어제 얘기한 것처럼 막 그 칠판 낙서 그냥 웃긴 거 할 때 장난친 적은 있어요.
Not really, not really. She, Jeonggi just kind of it's not tackled, but like There were moments where Jeonggi just kind of got into her way in drawings. Like she explained yesterday, she likes to draw on whiteboard and Jeonggi would just mess around with her drawings but never asked her a commission. Jeonggi or Hyunjin, Jeonggi doesn't ask her for her commission, but Hyunjin and Jeonggi both correct her drawings when it's needed.
되게 도움 되는 게
It's very helpful.
말도 안 되게 그려놓으면은 단어 와서 뭐라 그러거든요. 그래서 그런 게 되게
It's very helpful because when she has done a certain drawing and if the drawing doesn't make any sense, they would come and see the drawing and criticize the next day. So it's very helpful.
근데 다이버스틴 칭찬도 많이 주시고.
At the same time, they are not like a stiff like that all the time. When she has done a good drawing, they would like compliment her a lot.
비빌 언덕이 있는 것 같아서. 이게 항상 그림 그리다 보면은 잘하고 있는 건지 뭐 이상하게 하고 있는지 아무튼 걱정이 많이 되잖아요. 근데 저는 짜다 띄우면 되니까.
She's very satisfied with the situation because it's always good to have someone on your back. Because when you draw alone, there are a certain moment when you do not know, when you're not sure if you're doing right or not. But she doesn't have the feeling, she feels secure here. So she's very lucky.
저도 그 아까 연락 와서 좀 그림 좀 어떻게 하면 좋아질까 이런 연락 되게 많이 오는데 제가 알 일이 다 해주기 힘들어요. 그래서 초반에 좀 해줬는데 이제 못 해주겠더라고요. 근데 옆에 있으면 당연히 해주겠죠. 맞아. 그 사람이 찾아오면은 근데 정기 쌤이 항상 옆에 계시니까 좀 기쁘게 해주시고.
And she receives. It's true that she receives a lot of questions. From people who want to know how to improve their drawings, but it's kind of hard for her to explain all that when she's not around. It's not like as if it's not like as if the person come to visit Ms. Jisoo for advices. So that's why she cannot answer to everyone.
Guys, so we have three more minutes to go.
한 분 더 남았고요.
네.
After that, we'll have Dongho Kim joining in for a live drawing show. And Ms. Jisoo will be available for Art Jam 7:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. She also has online lecture course that's in English. For at cousinonline.com, because I do see a lot of questions to see her work process. I think through those lectures that's available online, you guys can definitely see her process more in depth. And she also teaches in Korea and through Chinese platform as well. So that's something that you guys should look into. And we still have some her original artwork on sale from superannyus.com. Her private commission are open as well. So yeah, please let us know if you guys have any question. And hopefully this whole COVID gets better next year so we can have her back in States.
Mm-hmm.
2분 남았어요, 아직.
아, 2분. 2분 동안 뭘 하지? 공산에 그랬군요.
지수쌤은 작년에 너무 재밌었는데, 그쵸, 우리?
그러니까.
행사.
아, 이번에 뉴욕 갈 수 있었잖아요.
Because last year, she participated in both San Diego and New York. It was super fun. 네. But hopefully we can hopefully we can travel back again.
언제 끝날까요?
다 했어요. 다 하셨어요, 선생님. 이제 인사하시고 네. 하시면 돼요.
이제 사인할 때 2021년 써야 될 때가 다가가잖아요.
Now, since it's the end of the year, it's nearly the moment where she has to sign 2021 instead of 2020. She's going to be a bit complicated for a while. It's going to be confusing for a while for her to sign.
2만이라고 쓰고. 2만이라고 쓰고.
네. Thank you so much, Miss Jisoo.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, 제가 잠깐 얼굴 보여드릴게요.
Who's
Thank you so much, Ms. Jisoo.
감사합니다.
Thank you.
So we're gonna have Dong-ho join us. 보인 쌤, 제가 동호 쌤 할 테니까 다음에 재광 쌤 부탁드릴게요.
어, 네, 알겠습니다.
예, 좀 쉬세요.
네, 감사합니다. 감사합니다.
수고하셨습니다.
감사합니다.
하이 동호.
나갔습니다.
헬로. 동호 쌤 들리세요? 오케이. Okay. 오디오가 안 돼요, 동호 쌤. 뮤트된 것 같은데.
헬로.
헬로.
잠깐만요, 이거를. 아, 여기서. 아, 이게 제가 오늘 두 개를 쳤거든요.
하나 오디오를 그냥 꺼주시면 될 것 같아요.
아, 오디오를?
하나만 들리는 거, 이게 더블로 들리니까.
오디오. 오디오 하나 꺾고.
말씀해 보세요, 한번.
아.
어, 계속 울리거든요. 그러니까 이게 스피커, 아. 예를 들어.
아.
스피커로 들리는 게 없어야 되는 거예요.
지금 맥북에서 왜 음소거 소리가 안 되지? 잠깐만요. 아, 괜찮은가요?
조금 아직 울려요. 뒤에서 뭔가가 들리는데
이거를 그냥 아, 네, 괜찮은가요?
네, 지금 좋아요.
아, 이거 연습을 많이 해야겠네. 제가 두 개를 쳤는데.
네.
이런 식, 잠깐만요. 그러면은 여기서 카메라를 저 얼굴로 비추고.
그렇죠.
오케이.
네, 좋습니다. Hi everyone. This is Dong-ho from South Korea. 인사말 한번 해 주세요.
안녕하세요. 어제 이어서 또 만나게 돼서 반갑습니다. 오늘 또 이렇게 스케줄을 잘 진행해 보겠습니다.
So I'm super happy to join SuperNikon Day 2, same as yesterday. So hopefully I'll put out a good show for you guys to enjoy. So here we go.
네, 혹시 질문이 있으면 질문을 해주시고 없으면은 이제 바로 본 스케줄을 들어가 보겠습니다.
If you guys have any question, please type in chat so I can answer your question as we go. And I'm gonna start drawing now. 네, 그림 먼저 그려주시면 제가 질문 읽도록 할게요.
네. 네, 이렇게 얇은 브러쉬 펜으로.
So today I'm going to use thin pencil brush pen. 오늘 뭘 그려주실 건가요?
오늘은 제가 자주 가는 식당에서 밥 먹고 있는 거 식당에서 밥 먹고 있는 걸 그리겠습니다.
So today I'm going to draw myself eating, having a meal at my favorite restaurant near home.
제가 맛있는 거 먹는 걸 굉장히 좋아해서요.
I'm such a foodie. I love eating. Great food. 지금 많은 분들이 인사해 주시고 계시고요. 가장 좋아하는 만화가 뭐냐고 물으십니다.
역시 저는 드래곤볼을 보면서 만화가의 꿈을 만들었기 때문에.
My favorite manga is Dragon Ball because that's what I grew up with, and while reading that, it really inspired me to become a cartoon artist, comic book artist.
대체적으로 어릴 때 일본 만화들을 이제 만화책 잡지를 사 보면서 이렇게 만화가 좋아졌습니다.
Since I was little, I loved purchasing collection of comics. So that really inspired me of becoming who I am. So question from Big Sun Nana. How do you know where to start your drawing? 어디서부터 그려야 되는지 어떻게 아세요?
어디서부터 그려야 하는지 미리 아는 게 아니고 이제 먼저 중심이 되는 거를 별 생각 없이 그리다가 거기에 맞춰서 이제 다른 것들을 맞춰 나갑니다.
I don't really define the final composition before I draw. I think about the primary drawing that's gonna occupy my canvas, and then basically just draw along with that. Burnout을 겪고 있는 사람들에게 어드바이스 줄 게 있으세요?
뭐 때문에 번아웃이 왔는지를 먼저 생각하는 게 중요하고. 그게 원인이 발견이 되면 그거를 먼저 없애기 위한 계획을 짜야겠죠.
So, question from Aina. What's your advice when having an art block or burnout? A response from Tongho is, first you have to figure out what makes you feel so burnout, and then you have to start admitting reasons why you feel that way first. I think that's always the first thing that you should consider to do. The second question from Budak Marvel. What are the most hard thing in art? 미술 그리 이제 그림 하면서 가장 힘든 점이 뭐예요?
일단 지금은 이제 프로 작가로 일을 하고 있기 때문에 지금 상태에 저한테는 이제 진짜 하고 싶은 그림만 그리면서 이제 더 집중적으로 일상 생계를 유지하는 그 일에 대한 고민이 가장 크겠죠.
Well, for me, as a professional artist, living, making money as a professional artist, my most concern these days and hard thing that I will consider is only by doing the favorite things that I wish to do in art, it is pretty hard to maintain living. That's the hard thing that I'm considering these days.
근데 가장 결정적인 고민은 근본적인 고민은 이제 정말 잘 그리고 싶은 욕망입니다.
But in the core of it, everything beneath my current problem or concern, one thing that I always consider as a big concerning issue for me is wanting to get better and eager to be better. A question from Anthony Tapia. Any tips when it comes to self-portrait? 자화상 그리는데 팁이 있으신가요?
자화상이라고 딱 정확히 말하기보다 사람을 이제 보고 비슷하게 그릴 때 이제 팁이라고 하면 저는 눈매를 연습을 많이 하는 것 같아요. 눈매가 비슷하게 나와지면 이제 그 외의 것들을 맞추기가 쉬운 것 같은데 그래서 눈 모양을 많이 연습해 보시길.
What I did as a student, I tend to exercise a lot on making the impression of the eye, basically make more like identical of how I look when I draw self-portrait, like impression that you deliver with your eye. So drawing an eye. So practicing how to draw an eye will really help you because typically in portrait, that's what people look at first.
아, 그리고 그 아까 전에 뭐라 그러지? 슬럼프라 그래야 되나? 번아웃이 왔을 때 거기에 대한 좀 답을 더 해드리면은
And to
기존에
continue question regarding a burnout.
기존에 이제 힘들게 하고 있는 일이 대부분 이제 내가 하고 싶은 걸 하지 못한 그림을 그린다거나 나한테 맞지 않는 일을 많이 할 때인데
Lot of times, artists get burned out because some of the work that you're assigned to do, sometimes you don't enjoy it. You think it's just you're just killing the time of just for the sake of work.
또 이제 내가 즐거워서 하고 있는 일이 어떤 평가에 의해서 자유롭지 못한 상태, 계속 평가에
Or,
의해서 나를 힘들게 하는 상태일 때 이겠죠.
sometimes artists do get criticized, of your favorite artwork that you made.
그런 상황에서 좀 벗어나서 내가 나만 재밌게 그릴 수 있는 그림을 많이 그릴 수 있는 상황을 만들어주면은 되게 좋을 것 같아요.
So imagine you're going through all those little concerning problems in your life. Imagine you're giving yourself a break by having an opportunity to draw whatever you want to make yourself feel better, which we'll call that as a personal work.
그림 자체가 이제 보기 싫을 정도로 힘들 수도 있는데,
Sometimes we get burnt out, so we don't even want to lift a pencil.
대부분 이제 그림이 정말 싫어졌다기보다는 이제 그림 때문에 일어난 상황들이 힘들어서 그런 걸 거라고 생각하거든요.
But if you're an artist, it doesn't mean that you start hating the act of art. We all love act of art, but we start to get burnt out and going into a slump because of the circumstance that we are in due to criticism, due to not having fun with a great time with the client, or just not satisfied with your current stage.
그래서 내가 그림 때문에 상처받는 일이 없도록 그 계획이라 그래야 되나? 그런 상황들을 항상 잘 만들어야 할것 같습니다.
So as an artist, to avoid that, you have to give yourself a platform where you can shine regardless by having fun with your personal drawing, personal hobby, so you get to actually enjoy purely in the act of drawing.
어차피 우리 자기의 그림이 모든 사람한테 사랑받을 수 없는 거는 또 당연한 일이기 때문에.
Because it is only natural for our artwork. Sometimes it's not meant to please everybody, meet everyone's standard.
본인 스스로 자기가 하는 일을 굉장히 사랑할 수 있다면 좋겠죠.
So you have to make yourself happy artist by enjoying and putting yourself in the situation where you can enjoy what you do. Great question and great answer. A question from Alan. What was your journey learning and mastering the brush pen? Did you always use it? 브러쉬 펜 쓰는 거 어떻게 연습하셨어요?
연습 방법을 굳이 얘기하면은 이제 머릿결 같은 경우가 이제 그리기 어렵잖아요. 머릿결 표현.
Well, one great exercise tip that I can give you, you know how it's pretty hard to draw hair.
그런 거를 딱 짧게 잡고 반듯하게 그리는 방법 있죠.
So, you know, imagine I'm drawing a hair. Then basically you do that this type of exercise.
그럼 펜도 마찬가지인데
Same with
같은
the
간격을
ballpoint
네.
pen.
같은 간격으로 같은 막 같은 간격을 반복해서 길게 그리는 연습도 막 시켰었거든요, 저 옛날에.
So as a warm up, try to really learn the property of each pen that offers by doing a warm up of drawing straight line from short to long.
학생 때는 이런 거 이렇게 격자로 그리기도 하고 이런 선 연습을 굉장히 많이 했던 것 같아요.
You know, as a student, I used to do this type of like cross hatching exercise, drawing straight line exercise with various pens. That's how you get familiar with the instrument that you have.
이런 연습하는 게 제가 학생 때는 주변에 좀꽤 있었던 것 같아요. 재밌어요, 이게.
And then I still enjoy doing this type of practice because isn't it fun?
이게 손에 적응을 시키는 거겠죠.
And we call this as a warm up because we're actually warming up to new materials that we happen to use. So you guys try this exercise. You'll be surprised how much it's going to help you. Question from Miss Murmur. What is one thing that you absolutely hate drawing if you even have something you hate to draw? 제일 그리기 싫어하는 것.
싫어하는 거는 없고요. 싫어하는 거 저는 그 그로테스크한 거를 좀 안 좋아하는 것 같아요. 너무 이제 어두운 그림.
So I don't think I have any particular object that I hate to draw, particular thing, but I do have a theme that I don't prefer to draw, which is kind of grungy theme, like kind of dark. question from Lissiti Meshiki. Do you have any tips on learning perspective and pushing expression as well as drawing like you do? 우선 perspective 그리는 거에 대한 팁이 있는지.
당연히 정말 기초적인 원리를 이론적인 거를 머릿속에 확실히 습득을 해야 돼요. 공부를 해야 돼요.
The thing about perspective, you have to know the very fundamental essential of a perspective.
그러면서 이제 실제 상황들을 보고 내 방이나 내가 다니는 사무실, 내가 자주 다니는 공간을 직접 눈앞에서 보고 그리는 게 도움이 되는 것 같아요.
And you have to do a lot of direct observation drawing. It could be your own bedroom, your office, on the way to your office, direct observation while applying the very essentials that you've learned in perspective. Guys, I see some questions regarding how many days is the con. So we initially it was 2 days. It was a 2-day event, which was yesterday and today. So today is the last day of a con. And yeah, it was super fun hanging out with you guys. And we have about 300 people watching this video. So thank you all for your support. I have a question from Nikki Ni. What do you do to stay motivated to draw? 어떻게 그림을 계속 그릴 수 있는 에너지를 얻으시는지 어디서? 아니면 어떻게?
크게 두 가지가 있는데 저는 배경 그리는 거를 좋아하기 때문에 재미있어 보이는 배경이 많은 곳을 좀 돌아다녀요. 재래시장 같은 곳을 좀 돌아다닙니다.
So one thing that I do is first I draw what I enjoy, which is for me is the environment. So I try to travel. I try to go places that's interesting to draw, such as right now since travel is restricted, I go to back street market. I love going to street market to draw a lot of different signage and street scene. So I put myself in the situation where I will enjoy to draw.
그런데 가서 이렇게 뭐 볼 일이 있어서 가면은 사람들 사이에 재밌는 어떤 스토리들이 보여요. 막 이렇게 대화하고 있는 사람들의 어떤 이렇게 대화를 듣다 보면은 재밌는 이야기들이 생기기도 하고 이렇게 평소에 보이는 것들을 그리길 좋아하기 때문에 그런 데서 스토리를 얻고요.
When you go to the marketplace, I sometimes often just listen to people just standing on the street just having a conversation. That means that source of a conversation because sometimes it can be the inspiration of my story as well. So I love drawing day-to-day scene. So that's why I like visiting different places where it has such a rich, vibrant subject to draw.
그리고 두 번째로는 좋아하는 작가들 전시를 가는 건데 요즘에 좀 힘들지만 전시회를 가서 그 작가를 벤치마킹한 그림을 그려보기도 해요.
And the second will be, of course, these days due to COVID-19, it is hard, but then I love going to exhibition. I love going to gallery. And I just love observing the energy that original arts has and then the essence. So I try to basically just draw like my favorite artists as a study, and hopefully I gain something out of it. For GIAL35, will the live video be available for to watch again even after it's over? Yes. Yes, my answer is yes. How from a question from Big Sun Nana, how much do you draw each day? 하루에 얼마나 그림 그리세요?
스케줄 때문에 그걸 정할 수는 없지만 제 그냥 기본적인 생각은 하루에 그냥 8시간, 10시간은 기본으로 그려야지 이 양심에 맞지 않나 싶습니다.
Due to my schedule, I don't know. I cannot track how many hours I draw per day, but then average, I don't think I'll feel bad if I don't draw more than 8 to 10 hours a day. So I think that's my goal, 8 to 10 hours a day.
하지만 그게 맨날 지켜진다면 정말 좋을 것 같습니다.
But it's not possible for me to do every. It's not easy to do. 8분 정도 남으셨어요? 아니다. 8분 정도 남으셨어요. So next we have Pyeongjun joining us for live drawing. I think it's gonna be more like live painting because he's a great concept artist based in South Korea. So yeah, please stay tuned. You guys will something very fun. Okay, so I think we have some time for a couple more questions. Kevin Norberg, do you have a specific place you'd love to visit just so you can draw in person?
기회가 되시면 나중에 실제로 꼭 가셔서 그림 그리고 싶은 장소가 있나요?
어디다 싶은 건 아니고 뭐 유럽이랑 이제 유럽을 많이 못 가봐서 유럽의 건물들 멋있는 건물들을 편하게 오랫동안 많이 그려보고 싶습니다.
I want to go to Europe because I haven't been many times. So I'd like to have a very relaxed trip so I can just sit there and draw until I can't. So that's what I would like to do.
또 인도에 가서 그림 일기를 많이 그려보고 싶어요. 이제 인도의 생활을 글 만화로 담는 일을 한번 해보고 싶어요.
And my next goal that I wish to do is to go to India, and observe how people live, and maybe turn them into more like a picture diary or maybe visual journal, so I can communicate their culture into a drawing. A question from Stevie Roder. I've noticed since I got back into drawing, I started to draw small again. How can I overcome this and to draw big? 그림 크게 그리는 거에 대한 팁이 있으세요? 큰 그림 잘 그리는 법.
큰 그림은 자료가 더 많이 필요하다. 뭐 굳이 작은 그림과 차이점이 있다면은 더 정확하게 자세하게 그려야 되기 때문에 충분한 자료들이 필요하지 않을까요? 그거 말고는 이제 많이 그려봐야겠죠.
For me, there's not much of a very specific tip that I can give you, but what I know is you have to know what you draw. So that means you have to prepare a lot of visual reference before you draw a big artwork because it does require a lot of textures and a lot more detail that goes in. So I'll do that. And then more than anything, you have to just throw yourself in there and just draw more. Joseph Lim, how do you draw from imagination? 상상력으로 어떻게 그림을 그리세요?
그 저 같은 경우는 기존에 봤던 것들을 이제 머릿속에 많이 기억을 하려고 하는 거고요. 없는 걸 그린다기보다 여기 지금 식당도 제가 자주 가는 식당의 구조를 지금 기억해서 거기에 뭐가 있었지? 뭐가 있었지? 이거를 기억해내는 중입니다.
For me, For instance, something that you guys are seeing right now, it's not drawn from imagination. I try to observe much as I can in person and utilize those visual memory, visual library when I draw without the reference. That's the one of the methods that I can introduce you guys.
여러분, 당장 여러분이 자주 신고 다니는 운동화를 안 보고 한번 그려보세요.
And for an instance, let's all try to draw one of your most worn shoes. Can you guys all draw that without looking at them?
그게 상상력입니다.
For me, that's an imagination. You're trying to remember what you saw before and try to just put it into your own interpretation. For me, that's drawing from imagination.
일단 내 주변에 있는 것부터 안 보고 그릴 수 있는 게 많아지게 되면은 그것들을 응용해서 또 새로운 것들을 그릴 수 있게 돼요.
The best way to exercise is try to remember the things that you've seen in life and draw. And if you are able to do it more objects than the other, then that's the very starting point of drawing from imagination.
당장 내 옆에 있는 것부터 또 내 집 주변에 있는 것들, 뭐 간판이나 뭐 에어컨 이런 생김새부터 하나하나 그려보는 거예요.
It could be a store signage. It could be fan in your home, it could be desk lamp, anything that you can see in person, you start drawing. All right, so we have two more minutes to go and we're gonna jump to Pyeongjun Park. Last question, I think this can be a last question from Dimachi Dave. Do you never mess up when drawing circle or sphere or square? 동그라미나 네모 상자 같은 거 그릴 때 망치시는 적 있으세요, 요즘?
지금도 망쳤습니다.
See, I made a mistake right now.
저도 right now. 반듯하게 이렇게 디자이너들처럼 이렇게 완전히 날카롭게 그리는 거를 잘하진 못해서 그 반듯하게 그리는 것보다 그냥 전체적인 비례감을 맞추는 거에 초점을 둡니다.
Look at my plate right now. I didn't even draw a perfect circle. You know, when you look at industrial designer, they are so great in perspective, so great in drawing perfect clean line, but I'm not. So I try to just have more correct aesthetic in proportion instead of clean line drawing.
다만 중요한 건 이렇게 내가 완전 원을 그릴 것이냐 타원형을 그릴 것이냐에 대한 구분 정도만 확실히 되면은 좋을 것 같아요.
So you don't have to be a, such a great, have a great draftsmanship by drawing perfect sphere or perfect square, but you have to know when you have to draw different types of a cylinder and different angle, depending on which perspective you're using. Okay, 시간이 다 됐습니다. Okay, so the time is up for Dongho. So we are taking private commission. So if you go to sobrinius.com, you will see some different options how to request a private, very your own personalized drawing from Dongho. We have some original artwork. We have really, really cute canvas tote bag that's made with his illustration as well. So please go visit our site. It's not too late. So yes, and thank you so much, Dongho. 카메라 한번 바꿔주셔서 인사 한번 해줄 수 있으세요?
네, 감사합니다.
하고 싶으신 말 있으세요?
열심히, 요즘 밖에 못 나가는 만큼 집에서 더 열심히 그림 그리면 좋을 것 같아요.
So, really great to see you guys. I'm sad that I don't get to see you guys in person. Since due to COVID-19 with more strong restriction that we are all experiencing worldwide, let's just try to utilize this time to draw more at home and just get better. Become a better artist. Thank you so much for watching. 수고하셨습니다.
네, 수고하셨습니다.
Yeah, and we have 평준 who's joining us soon. 평준 쌤, 제 목소리 들리세요? Dongho and 평준 will join us for the art jam that starts at 7:30 Pacific Standard Time. So we have Peter, Han, Eliza, Kim Jung-gi, Miss Chisu, Dongho, Pyeongjun, Jaegwang, and Nicholas Nemery, who will be joining us for the art jam using Magma Studio. So we have Pyeongjun. 안녕하세요. He is connecting to audio right now. 안녕하세요. 들리세요?
네, 들려요.
오케이. 인사말 한번 부탁드릴게요.
아, 잠시만요.
네.
아, 다시 한번 말씀해 주시겠어요?
네, 인사말 한번 부탁드릴게요.
아, 네, 네, 네. 안녕하세요, 여러분. 어제부터 해 가지고 오늘도 저는 이제 디지털 일러스트 작가다 보니까 오늘 포토샵으로 이렇게 시연하는 거 보여 드리고 하려고 합니다. 잘 부탁드립니다.
Hi everyone. My name is Pyeongjun. I am a concept artist based in South Korea. So this is my day 2 with SuperAnyCon. Super stoked to see everyone here. So today I am going to share my screen and give you guys a tour of how I work in Photoshop. 보인 씨 제 말 들리세요? 네, 보인 씨 오디오가 지금 네.
오늘 이렇게 작업하는 것도 궁금해하실 것 같아서
됩니다.
그냥 저는 이런 신티크 좀 쓰고 있고요.
제가 하나요? 네. 네. So, Pyeongjun is saying that he is going to show you what kind of tool he uses, and so he uses Cintiq as he showed it right now.
네, 화면도 보이시나요?
아니요. 화면은 아직 누르면, 보이지 않아요.
공유 누르면 되나요?
네, 공유.
네, 지금 눌러놓은.
예, 잘 보입니다.
So now we see what Pyeongjun Park sees on his screen. And he's going to demonstrate his work on Photoshop 쓰시는 거죠?
네네네.
On Photoshop.
근데 그냥 시간이 이렇게 많지가 않으니까 이렇게 뭐 인물 같은 거 그려보면서 이것저것 뭐 궁금하신 거나 이런 거 있으면은 같이 얘기하면서 해보면 좋을 것 같아요.
So what he is going to do today, since he has only 30 minutes, he's just going to draw a character, a person, and then he will be receiving questions from you guys and try to, you know, chat with you guys today.
신티크 16인가요? 아니면 와컴 1인가요?
신티크 16인치 프로 버전 쓰고 있어요.
He is using Cintiq 16 Pro version, version Pro.
At Wacom
One. 네.
바꾼 지 얼마 안 돼서 아직 좀 적응하는 중인데.
He is adjusting himself to the Cintiq because it has not been that that long since he has been using it.
요즘 같은 경우에 개인적으로 좀 이렇게 많이 그려보고 있는 재미있는 소재가 있어가지고 그것도 그려보면 좋지 않을까.
He's going to draw something that he has been drawing a lot these days.
별건 아니고요, 사실.
It's nothing. It's nothing like special, but.
아이돌 캐릭터 그리고 있어요.
He is actually drawing a character, an idol character.
이렇게 뭐라고 해야 되지?
황준 씨?
네네.
아 아니죠, 아 소리가 끊긴 줄 알고.
네.
평준 개인 방송도 하시나요?
아 네네, 지금 요즘에 하고 있어요.
And he is also doing a personal streamings on internet too.
네, 유튜브랑 트위치로 하고 있는데
He's just a beginner, but he is a streaming on YouTube and Twitch.
그런데 영어를 못해서 뭔가 외국 분들이 가끔 오시기는 하는데 뭔가 대답을 못해가지고 아쉽네요.
And he is a bit sad because there are sometimes people from English-speaking countries who come visit his page, his channel. But since he cannot really speak English, he has a difficulty in responding to them. So he finds it a bit stressful.
작업 과정 같은 것도 좀 궁금해하시는 분들이 많은데, 저는 이제 옛날에 좀 안 좋을, 그러니까 지금보다 이게 상황이 안 좋을 때부터 이렇게 화면에 그리는 걸 많이 하다 보니까 스케치 하기가 좀 힘들다 보니까 약간 이런 식으로 처음에 많이 그렸던 것 같아요.
상황이 안 좋다는 게 어떤 뜻이세요?
그러니까 막 컴퓨터 사양이 별로 안 좋으니까 좀 느리니까 스케치가 좀 마음대로 안 돼서 그래가지고 그냥 바로 이런 식으로 채색부터 이렇게 올리는 식으로 많이 그렸던 것 같아요.
So as you can see, he doesn't start the drawing. He doesn't start the drawing by sketching. He goes straight into colors. And people have been wondering why he is why he adapted himself to this kind of work procedure. It's because he has been working on computer for a very long time. And before, when he did not have Cintiq, the computer was very slow and the lines did not come out the way he wanted. It was very slow. So he started just to apply the colors first and then go into the details. So yes, that would be the reason why he starts with the shape rather than making a line drawing.
지금이야 이제 이렇게 하다 보니까 익숙해져가지고 뭔가 노하우 같은 것도 많이 쌓였어요.
Now he has a lot of experience in starting with the shape first. So he's very used to it. A question from Maria. How old is Pyeongjun and how long has been drawing? 몇 살이시고 얼마나 오래 그림을 그리셨는지?
저는 지금 이제 한국 나이로 35이고 그림가 제가 그림 얼마나 그렸나? 제대로 이렇게 배운 거를 이제 물어보시는 거겠죠? 그러면은 그래도 한 19 정도니까 그래도 꽤 오래 그렸죠. 한 10몇 년 그린 셈이죠. 한 15년?
15년.
더 됐겠다. 한 15년 정도? 예, 예.
So, he is 35 years old in Korean age. So his international age is 33. And he has been drawing for around 15 years now.
I think digital, like, well, I'm going to say, 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 I'm going to say,
So people wonder, people find it interesting that he does not make any sketches before he goes into the detail. But Pyeongjun personally thinks that the only difference is that he is using a Cintiq, a computer, but the procedure is quite the same. It's just that the procedure of drawing is quite the same as other artists. It's just that he starts with a silhouette, the shape, and then he adds the detail onto it.
좀 단순하게 가야겠어요. 지금 제가 너무 시간에 지금 뭔가 압박이 있는지 모르겠는데.
Now he's realizing that he really don't have that much time, so he's going to simplify his drawing.
물론 제 이제 방송에 보시면은 이것저것 많이 그린답니다.
Mm-hmm. And if you guys are interested, please visit his channel on YouTube and Twitch because he draws quite a lot of things.
약간 이렇게 그린 거 장점 알려드리자면은 얼굴을 그냥 이렇게 만화처럼 좀 처음에 이렇게 단순하게 먼저 인상 같은 단순하게 인상을 이렇게 만들어 볼 수가 있어요. 좀 만화적으로 접근을 해서 그래서 제가 그리는 캐릭터에 먼저 이렇게 딱 떠오르는 이미지를 이렇게 좀 만화적으로 예를 들어서 저는 약간 장난기 있어 보이려고 해가지고 약간 간단하게 치면 약간 이런 눈 이렇게 좀 생각해가지고 지금 디자인 중이에요.
So one of the Pyeongjun is saying that one of the advantages of starting right away with the shape is that it's more easier to play with the expression of the character. With a touch of comic. Now he is trying to make an impression where the character is a little bit like a very playful, humorous. So he is modeling, he's designing the face that way, with that touch of a comic on its eyes.
이런 식으로 좀 생각해서 하면은 아무래도 처음부터 막 이제 리얼하게 좀 더 사람을 실제 사람처럼 이렇게 묘사를 한다 그래도 처음에 약간 이렇게 만화적으로 특징을 잡고 들어가면은 그런 뭔가 개성을 여전히 가진 채 이렇게 얼굴을 그릴 수가 있어서 좀 다양한 뭐랄까 성격을 가진 그런 인물들을 좀 그릴 수 있는 것 같아요.
So one of the reasons one of the advantage of sculpting a face or expression like this going through the shape first is that you can easily concentrate on the individuality, the personality of the character before making it realistic. So it's more easy to keep that characteristic on the character.
So, 그 정도가 진행된 다음에는 이제 얼굴 구조에 맞춰서 어디에 이렇게 눈이 어느 정도 크기로 들어가고 또 이제 코 위치는 또 어느 정도고 이런 것들이 좀 상상하기가 쉬우니까 이제 좀 뭐랄까 아까는 제가 이제 이 인물을 예를 들어서 한 20, 30m 거리에서 보는 상황인 거예요. 그 정도에서 이제 어느 정도 묘사를 하고 있었어요. 아직은 좀 더 해야 될 단계이긴 한데 아무튼 그렇게 좀 멀리서 보는 인물처럼 딱 상상을 하고 그 다음에 좀 더 이제 이 사람을 제가 가까이서 눈앞에서 봤을 때 어떻게 보이는지 뭐 이런 식으로 상상하면서 그리는 편이에요.
So how he approaches, how he approaches the drawing is that firstly he would imagine that he is seeing this person from 20 to 30 meters away, so from far away. So he would just sculpt your whole body based on that imagination, and then after working on the shape, he would imagine himself looking at the person right in front of her. And then he would calculate the position of the nose and the eyes and the size of the eyes. So he starts off imagining things from far away in this drawing. And then he would, secondly, and then he would approach himself to the character to imagine what she would look like from a closer view.
저는 이렇게 이제 과정을 갖다 보니까 한 가지 장점이 있다면은 좀 빠른 시간 안에 이렇게 전체 느낌을 좀 빨리 잡을 수가 있는 것 같아요.
And when you approach the drawing like Pyeongjun does, the advantage of is the advantage of Pyeongjun's way of drawing is that you can easily build up a whole structure more fastly, more rapidly. 트위치 채널 혹시 이름 어떻게 되시나요?
아, 그게 제 아이디로 돼 있어가지고
네. 알파벳 불러주시면 사람들이 궁금해서 찾고 있어서
잠시만요. 네. 저도 헷갈려서
아, 그렇군요. He's going to give you guys the his Twitch account. He cannot recall it properly.
아, 이거다. 여기다 그냥 써드릴게요.
He's going to write on his Cintiq. 평준 Park and 재광 Park aren't brothers. 재광 씨랑 형제냐?
아, 아니요, 아니죠.
No.
저희는 형제가 아닙니다.
They 저는... aren't brothers.
네. 여기 뭐야, 아직... 아, 만든 지 얼마 안 돼서 잘 할 줄도 모르고 라이브로밖에 안 하고 있어요.
So he's really new to Twitch. He's only using the channel on live. 그 머리는 그러니까 머리카락은 그럼 언제쯤 시작하시나요? 머리카락 묘사는?
뭐 그것도 지금 바로 해도 되는데 지금은 이제 한번 해볼까요? 말 나온 김에 어떤 헤어가 어울릴지 좀 생각 중이었어요.
At what stage does he start the hair? He could start at any time, really. He was just right now. He was just thinking what kind of hairstyle would fit into the character, so he was just imagining things.
뭐 혹시나 어떤 헤어가 어울릴지 좀
Do you have any ideas? Yeah. If you guys have any suggestions, please feel free to suggest 평준 Park. 아니면 대머리일 수도 있겠군요. 누가 댓글에 달았습니다. Plot twist, she's actually bald.
아이돌이 대머리 하는 거 좀 드물죠.
a pop star cannot really be bald, so he's going to add hair still.
아무래도 실루엣을 처음에 정한 거다 보니까 아직 많이 묘사 안 한 상태에서 좀 이걸 빨리 좀 이제 다듬어 주는 것도 필요한 것 같아요. 아까 약간 이제 처음에 그냥 딱 떠오르는 대로 했던 거 그걸 그대로 끝까지 가져가는 건 아니고 중간쯤에 약간 달라질 부분이 있다거나 하면은 조금 더 섬세하게 이제 이렇게 다듬어 주면 되는 것 같아요.
And even though he shaped the character firstly, it doesn't mean that the shape will stay the same until the end. He's going to, how would we say that? He would like polish the figure, the form of the figure now and then, and make it more natural. His style is very painterly. 되게 이렇게 페인터 약간 이렇게 화가 같은 느낌으로 접근을 하시는군요라고 누군가가.
그런 건가요? 저는 사실 이제 지금 약간 해보고는 싶은데 유화라든지 이런 것도 한번 해보고 싶어서 아직까지 경험은 없는데 아마 제가 생각하기에도 유화를 제가 만약에 그린다면 비슷한 방식으로 하지 않을까 싶긴 해요.
Very painterly style. He's not sure, but he has been thinking about doing some paintings, oil paintings, for example. He has never done it, but if he actually starts doing it, he thinks that he's going to use the same method as now he is doing on Cintiq. Layer와 brush 선택을 잘 보여요. 다른 방송 볼 때는 레이어 위에 얼굴 창 띄어서 안 보였어요라고 합니다.
아, 근데 레이어 제가 이쪽에 별로 손을 안 대긴 하는데.
Nikki, Byungjun said that it's true that he doesn't really touch layer. He doesn't really fiddle with the layers. He works like a sculptor, sculpting out shape rather than drawing out the outline lines. 약간 접근 방식이 그거 같다고 조각하시는 분 같다고 멋있다고 합니다.
아, 근데 사실 그게 맞는 것 같아요. 그 조각같이 그러니까 처음에 이렇게 큼직하게 좀 실루엣을 만들어 놓고 정말 그 안에 조금씩 굴곡을 이렇게 만들어 나가는 거죠, 결국은.
He thinks that's what he does. So he paints the whole form, the shape, the silhouette firstly, and then he would just he would curve it out, the details.
Well, 이런 데 이제 좀 재미 요소를 이렇게 치마 같이 이런 것도 한번 넣으면 좋을 것 같아요.
So he's working on details right now. He's going to add something on the pants so that it's half pants and half skirt.
About 7 minutes left. 그렇지는 않은데 지금은 일단 최대한 빨리 이렇게 하기 위해서 하는 것도 있긴 해요. 그 지금 쓰는 게 이제 이것도 좀 궁금해하시는 분들이 은근히 있었는데 이제 보시면은 그렇게 크게 이렇게 오퍼시티가 많은 그러니까 투명도 조절을 딱히 안 하면서 이렇게 칠을 해요. 근데 이제 러프 이렇게 좀 빨리 초반에 만들어 나가는 단계에서는 그런 브러쉬가 안 필요하다고 생각을 하거든요, 저는.
그리고 레이어도 하나만 쓰시는지.
그거는 사실 딱히 이유가 있는 건 아닌데 이거 인물 같은 게 이제 어쨌든 하나 이렇게 묘사하는 거니까 이제 필요가 없어서 지금 안 하는 거긴 한데요. 레이어 같은 경우는 저는 이제 말 그대로 딱 필요할 때만 써요. 그러니까 제가 구분해 가지고 그리는 게 편할 때 그럴 때만 쓰지 굳이 이렇게 조금 하고 뭐 이렇게 약간 보존하는 의미로 이렇게 레이어 쓰시는 분들도 있더라고요. 앞에 그린 것들 이렇게 안 지워지게 그냥 보존하려고 그런 거는 크게 의미가 없는 것 같아요.
Is he just going to use one layer? Yes. He thinks that he doesn't really need various layers when he is just drawing one character. He uses lots of layers when it's only needed. Sometimes he knows that people uses a lot of layers to preserve the drawing so that the sometimes the line work or sometimes the colors don't disappear, but he doesn't think that he needs that. It's very, he doesn't think that procedure is needed. He only uses numerous layers when he wants to separate the character and the background, something like that. And do you only use one brush type? Not always. He's only using one brush type today because he has to go fast because he has only 30 minutes. And he thinks that you don't need that many of a brush when you're just doing the rough.
아, 그 아까 그 얘기를 좀 부연 설명하자면은 이렇게 투명도가 딱히 없는 브러쉬 쓰는 게 처음에 약간 여러분들이 이제 스케치하는 느낌 때문에 이렇게 좀 이렇게 삭삭 약간 투명도가 있어가지고 이렇게 스케치하듯이 이렇게 브러쉬질을 하시는 분들이 있는데 저는 채색에서는 이거는 좀 잘못된 표현이라고 생각을 해요. 왜냐면은 투명도가 들어가는 것 자체만으로 그냥 말하자면 다른 색이 칠해지는 거거든요. 그러면은 그 중간중간 색을 자기가 이렇게 좀 골라서 칠해야 좀 더 자기가 원하는 분위기가 나오는데 어떻게 보면은 좀 손쉽게 이렇게 하려고 그렇게 투명도가 있는 브러쉬를 쓰는 경우가 많은데 저는 그렇게 되면 엄밀히 말하면 다른 색을 칠하고 있는 거라서 자칫하면 분위기가 깨질 수도 있다고 생각을 해요.
Talking about the brush. Yeah, now he is using a brush the colors without any opacity at all. And he knows that there are some people who changes opacity when they're sketching or coloring. But he thinks that for him, at least, that it's a wrong approach to paint. Because if you change the opacity to be in reality, if you change the opacity of a brush or a color, basically you're going to apply a different color. And since you're not painting with a certain color, but by changing the opacity, you're actually applying a different color than you planned in the first place. It might change the whole atmosphere. So he tries to avoid to change the opacity of the color or the brush when he paints.
<이게 너무 작가분들이 많아져서 뭔가 혹시 아무리 생각해도 30분 너무 짧은 것 같습니다.
다음에는 늘리도록 하겠습니다, 작가님. 근데 30분 치고 너무 많이 하셨어요.
네? 그거 아니 어쨌든 미완성인데.
이걸 누가 합니까, 30분 안에.
단면 맞아야지.
아, 그쵸. 아, 맞다. 입시 때 느낌으로 한번 최대한 빠르게. 짧으니까 말이 좀 없어졌어요.
Yes, I'm speeding up, so he's not talking that much. He's not talking too much.
이제 시간이 다 네. 됐습니다.
알겠습니다.
Okay, so time is up. So we're gonna wrap up with Pyeongjun and Jaegwang Park will join us.
그래도 좀 짧은 시간에 꽤 인상은 나오지 않았나 싶어요. 약간 완성됐을 때 느낌을 미리 알 수 있는 정도?
So, since he did not have that much time, he didn't want to zoom in into the drawings, but he did anyways. And as you can see, because he, it's not, the face is not sculpted perfectly, but he applied anyways. He applied all the colors that he needed onto the face, so we can actually see what kind of expression that she has, she will have at the end, in the end, when he finishes the painting. So it's really just the...
Awesome. 인사 한번 해주세요, 작가님. 잠시만요, 네. 카메라 한번 바꿀게요.
네.
혹시 스크린 공유 풀어주실 잠시만요. 수 있으세요?
아니, 아까 어떻게 했더라?
아, 제가 하겠습니다.
네네. 화면 공유가 아니고 비디오는 지금 틀어져 있지 않나요?
네, 지금 평준 선생님 얼굴 나와요. 인사 한번 해주세요.
아, 나오겠어요?
네.
네, 오늘 봐주셔서 감사하고요.
Thank you everyone for watching today.
네, 나름 방송 요즘에 이제 열심히 하려고 시작 막 한 참이니까 말은 안 통하더라도 그림이라도 이렇게 구경하면서 같이 작업하는 시간 보내면 좋을 것 같아요.
So he, as he said before, he recently started his YouTube channel and Twitch. Even though he cannot speak English, he would like to share the interesting drawings with all the people who wants to know how he draws.
네. 봐주셔서 감사합니다.
Thank you for
감사합니다.
watching.
수고하셨어요. Great. So, all right. So we have Jaegwang here. Hi everyone. So we have Jaegwang here. He's based in South Korea.
인사 한번 해주세요, 재광 선생님.
네. 안녕하세요.
Hello.
박형준 작가랑 형제인 박재광입니다.
So the older brother of Pyeongjun Park, as you guys asked before, they are brothers. So Pyeongjun said that it was a false information.
보인 씨 이번 거 제가 할게 한번 쉬세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
All right, sounds great. So 오늘 어떤 거를 보여주시나요?
저요? 캐릭터를 그릴 텐데 용 드래곤헌터 느낌으로 하고 싶습니다.
Okay, so today he's gonna show us his live drawing of a dragon hunter. So I'm super excited. So we have received many private commission pieces for him, actually quite large ones. He is still receiving few more. So please visit our website, supernews.com, click on commission, and then you can see some various options for him. So we're gonna switch his screen to his canvas.
화면 한번 바꿔주세요. 그림 네. 보일 수 있게.
Great, so I assume that everyone can see. His canvas. Wow. 다들 너무 반갑다고 얘기해 주시네요.
반갑습니다.
So we are accepting questions. So please let us know if you guys have any question on the live chat. So he is saying no questions for me. I guess I'll just concentrate on my drawing. 30분 동안 어느 정도 네. 완성하실 네. 수 있을 것 같아요. A question from Lean Jenny's. How much does Choi Kwang expect to get done in 30 minutes?
제가 캐릭터 한 명까지 다 될 것 같고 혹시 용을 까지 그릴 수 있을 것 같습니다. 좀 빠르게 된다면 네.
I think I can get done in one full character. So hopefully I have some time for dragon as well. Question from draw anything. 어떤 펜 쓰고 있는지 좀 보여 주실 수 있으세요?
아트라인 제가 즐겨 쓰는
This is 드라인. One of my favorite pen by Artline 0.9. A question from Bacon Tastes Like Dogs. Do you have a favorite thing to draw? 그리기 좋아하시는 거 있으세요?
저는 뭐 타투도 좋아하고요.
I like drawing
용 같은 거 그린 거 좋아.
I like drawing things for tattoo and for video game. 혹시 is Terada one of his influence? 혹시 테라다 카츠야 선생님이 네. 존경하는 분 중에 한 명인가요? 영향 받은?
물론이죠.
Of course. A question. What are the most important thing to learn to draw as good as you? 재경 선생처럼 잘 그리려면 중요한 부분이 뭐예요?
발버둥 쳐야 됩니다.
You have to try extremely hard. Be desperate to be good.
왜냐면은 어렸을 때부터 본 선생님이 김정기 선생님이어서
Because a teacher I seen since I was a student it was Kim Jong-gi. So of course you have to try your best to be good.
웬만해서는 버틸 수가 없습니다.
So if you're just around average, you cannot be taught from him, by him. Yes, this is an art line pen. How many years have you been drawing? 몇 년 동안 그리셨어요?
15년?
I am guesstimating around 15 years. What is his favorite medium to work on? Pen, pencil, watercolor, or any other things? 어떤 재료 쓰는 거 제일 좋아하세요? 그림 그리실 때?
예전에는 수채화를 즐겼었는데.
Before I used my preferred material to use was watercolor.
요즘에는 코픽 마카를 거의 주로 쓰고 있습니다.
These days I use Copic marker the most.
And
the Copic marker from Korea, Copic marker Korea is sponsoring as well. So yeah, I have easy access to Copic marker and it became one of my favorite things to use.
안 쓰면 뭐라고 혼납니다.
If I don't use it, I'll get in trouble by Copic marker. 어릴 적부터 그림 그리는 거 즐기셨다면 어떤 거 그리는 거 제일 좋아하셨어요?
미국 만화 뭐 아직도 기억나는 건 이제 헬보이 뭐 스파이더맨 이런 거 그리는 거 좋아했고요. 그리고 드래곤볼 정말 많이 따라했어요.
I used to love drawing Spider-Man and American superhero comic book and also Dragon Ball. 네. Would commissioners be able to request for color watercolor instead of Copic? 혹시 커미션 프라이빗 네. 커미션 할 때 수채화로 네. 해주실 수 있는 거 리퀘스트 받으시나요?
네, 수채화로만도 받습니다.
Yes, of course. You can just email that you prefer using watercolor, then he'll use watercolor instead of Copic marker. 기억하고 그리시는 것들, 보지 않고 그리시는 것들 중에 제일 중요한 것은 뭐예요?
그렇게 하기 위해서 정말 많이 저 같은 경우는 그리고 싶은 걸 많이 따라 그렸어요.
For me to draw without using reference from my imagination, I practice a lot by not looking. Is he considering getting an iPad now after yesterday's art jam? 어제 아이패드 써보신 이후로 아이패드 사실 생각이 있으세요?
네, 좋은 것 같더라고요.
Yeah, why not? I really enjoyed using it.
이제 아트잼은 괜찮으셨는지 모르겠네요.
Hope you guys enjoy the art jam. I just want to hear how you guys think. Do you ever plan your drawing with pencil or usually straight drawing pen? 연필로 스케칭하고 하세요? 아니면 바로 그냥 펜으로 그리세요?
평소 작업할 때는 진짜 꼼꼼하게 스케치하는 편이에요.
Typically when I draw, I really do a detailed drawing with using my pencil. So I tell my other fellow artists as well, if you can, if you're able to, try to do a lot of underline sketch first.
그러다 보면 어느 순간 안보 스케치 없이도 좀 되는 때가 오더라고요.
So if you start to do that, someday you won't need any underline drawing, just like what I'm doing. But in the beginning of my career, I used to just draw lot in details using pencil. 그림 그리실 때 어떻게 사람 인체를 생각을 하고 그리시는지?
일단은 자료를 정말 많이 모으고요. 인스타, 뭐 보디빌더, 뭐 화보 모델들 이런 거 정말 많이 모으고요.
I do collect a lot of reference. It could be from Instagram, it could be from figure drawing website, it could be from a magazine of a bodybuilder. I do collect a lot of reference that's related to human anatomy.
어떤 장면을 그릴 때 아, 내가 모았던 자료들이나 이런 데서 아, 영감을 조금 얻는 편이에요.
So I often get a great inspiration by flipping through the reference that I collected personally.
그 전에는 인체 공부를 정말 많이 해야 됩니다. 많이 따라 그리고.
But before that, you guys do have to have a very good idea in human anatomy.
많이 혼나고.
And you have to be taught in tough ways by your teachers as well.
시간 많이 있죠?
지금 10분 남았습니다. Would Park, would Jaegwang prefer to draw female or male? 여자 남자 중 그리는 것도 좋아하는 거 있으세요?
남자 좋아합니다.
I like drawing male figure. Who are some of your favorite artists? 좋아하시는 작가들 있으세요?
김정기 선생님 제일 좋아하고요.
I like 김정기.
그리고 뭐 일본에는 토리야마 아키라 작가님, 테라다카츠 작가님 좋아해요.
For Japanese artists, Toriyama, Toriyama Akira, and I like Terada Katsuya. What are your favorite concepts to draw? 그리기 좋아하는 장르 물 있으세요?
약간 액션이나 판타지 이런 류 좀 좋아하는 것 같아요.
I like more fantasy driven and something that's more active, something that's more has a lot of different varieties in motion. How does he come up with the different character designs while drawing? 지금처럼 뭐 보고 그리시는 게 아닌데 어떻게 캐릭터 디자인을 이렇게 하시는 거예요?
좀 평소에 그리고 싶어하는 컨셉들을 많이 적어놓는 편이에요.
Typically, whenever I have a new idea in terms of a character exploration, I just take down a lot of notes of what the idea that comes across my mind.
컨셉만 많고 그리질 못해서 그게 더 문제예요.
I do, believe me, I do have so many ideas, but I just don't have enough time to draw all of them. Do you ever have days where it's hard for you to draw? 그리기 정말 그림 잘 안 되는 날 있나요?
항상 그런 편인 것 같아요. 그래서 맨날 그래도 이 그림을 마무리 지어야겠다는 사명감으로 항상 그립니다.
I often do confront difficult to draw times that I have difficult to draw. But then a lot of times my major motivation is to finish the current drawing that I have. So that's my motivation.
그래서 제가 좀 다른 것들보다 좀 내세울 수 있는 장점은 인내심이 조금 있는 것 같아요.
I'm sure one of the things that I can say that I am better than other artists is I have a good patience. How do you keep your fantasy concepts believable? 판타지물을 사실화스럽게 어떻게 믿을 수 있게 그리는 방법이 있으세요?
일단 기본 제 그림체가 좀 사실 바탕으로 좀 되어 있어서 사실적인 인체 드로잉을 일단은 좀 알아야 될 것 같아요.
Just to begin with my style, I think I draw things pretty realistically. So that's first. And if you want to make a fantasy, it could be creature, it could be character, it could be armor, anything that you see that you want to add a fantasy element, you have to know what it can look like in real life.
형준 작가님이 이번 제 시간 잡아먹었죠.
살짝.
아, 그래도.
필리핀에서 인사를 하시네요.
어, 헬로.
오늘 알트잼은 무슨 주제로 하게 되는지 알고 계세요?
식사? 잘 모르겠어요.
아침 각자의 아침 식사래요. 아, so today's topic for art jam that starts at 7:30 Pacific Standard Time. The topic to draw is your breakfast. The topic is your breakfast. So we have, I think we have a time just for one more question. So, what is most inspiring to you in daily life? 제일 영감 가는 순간이 언제예요? 하루 중?
인스타 볼 때요. 다른 작가님들 그림 볼 때.
When I look at Instagram, observing other artists' work.
정말 캡처를 많이 하는 편이에요.
I save a lot of their work for my own inspiration archive. And also when I visit Super Annie office in Paju in South Korea, I don't work here, but then often I make a visit. Whenever I come, I just dig through their cabinets with full of Kim Jong-il's original work, and that becomes such a great inspiration for me.
부럽죠.
I really admire him. 재광 선생님은 30분이 짧게 전혀 안 느껴지는데요, 지금.
저 이거 5분 더 줘야 되는데. 좀 천천히 그랬어요.
Jaegang said, I deserve 5 more minutes to finish this off.
5분만 더 주면 여기 용머리 이렇게 그리려고 그랬었는데.
네, 5분 더 드리겠습니다.
그려도 될까요?
예,
감사합니다.
5분 더 드리겠습니다. Nicholas, Jaegang wants to draw a dragon head, so let's give him 5 more minutes, and then Nicholas' session will be 5 minutes extended as well.
콜라 팬들한테는 너무 죄송하다고 해주세요.
Sorry for fans who's been waiting for Nicholas, but I have to draw dragon head. You guys have to see this. How many hours do you draw in a day? 하루에 몇 시간 정도 그림 그리세요?
안 그릴 때도 있기는 한데.
Some days 거의... I don't draw at all.
만화 원고 하거나 이럴 때 바쁠 때는 한 진짜 14시간씩 그리기도 해요.
But when I'm but when I work such as comic book or comic book cover any commission work sometimes I draw 14 hours straight.
목표한 양을 못 하고 하면 잠이 안 와 가지고
Because when I don't fulfill some of the work that's assigned to me, I often cannot go to sleep. So I tend to finish what I have and then try to rest after.
Three
How do you deal with creative block? 창의력이 없을 때 어떻게 해결하시는지.
조금 어려운 질문입니다. 저는 항상 그리고 싶은 게 목록이 가득 차 있어서.
That's pretty hard question for me because I have a list of things, so many things that I wish to draw.
근데 예전에 저도 공부를 한참 할 때는 좀 그런 적이 있어서 종이를 펴면은 뭘 그려야 될지 모를 때
But when I was a student, I remember I had several times of just having difficult time not knowing what to draw on the blank piece of paper.
그럴 때마다 이제 좋아하는 장면을 많이 따라 그렸어요.
Whenever I get that time that I didn't know what to draw, I often studied and copied a lot of scenes, one of the favorite scenes that I see in movies or books.
그래서 전 다른 분들하고 좀 다르게 저는 그런 공부하시는 분들한테 모작을 정말 많이 하는 편이에요.
So I'm not sure how other artists will feel, but I often tell my art tell artists who wants to get better to do a lot of master copies.
네, 거의 끝나가죠.
Yeah, I'm almost done. So Nicholas will be here very soon. Yeah, I think I am done. Mm. 작가님, 제가 얼굴 잠시 보여드릴게요.
네, 잘 보셨는지 모르겠습니다.
Hope you guys enjoyed.
다음에 더 많은 작업도 보여드리고 카존이나 슈퍼엔 통해서 많이 뵙겠습니다.
So I will draw more. I will try to get better. And next time when I see you guys, hopefully we can do some collab with Spurani through Spurani and Kazon channel so I get to interact with you guys more. Thank you so much for watching. 감사합니다.
네.
수고하셨어요. Hi, Nicholas.
Hey. Hi, Nico. Hey.
How is it going?
I'm good.
Good? All right. So are you ready to do this?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Okay.
So Nicholas, today I think we have a better setup than yesterday. So I'm super excited to see your life drawing. So do you have an idea what to draw?
Yeah. Okay, I start.
Yeah, what are you going to draw today?
Kids and animals, but maybe two kids.
Okay.
Maybe it's two. Better. Okay, let's do. Yeah, maybe it's too much space. Okay.
No, it looks great. I mean, the contrast, the details, it looks great, Nick.
Okay, cool.
They're saying, hello, Nicholas. We love Nicholas' style.
I hope I will do good.
You will. And Sungmin is saying, love hearing his voice so laid back.
Oh, thanks.
Love the contrast with both artists. Nemiri's style is so unique and dynamic. They are requesting, Nicholas, please do a watercolor finish.
Mm-hmm. What you say, sorry?
They said, please finish, please do a watercolor finish.
Oh, I will try. I don't prefer that. Okay.
No worries, no pressure. Nicholas, can we zoom out just a little bit? Thank you. Yeah, looks great. Nicholas, do you have any advice or tips in drawing dynamic poses?
You mean like with a model or something?
No, just a drawing with dynamic pose.
Like I said yesterday, actually, just look at, just, okay. The first one, you start to draw in beginning, don't put too much pressure, is try to have fun, to make feel it. And, just start very simple and try to have fun and little by little, challenge yourself. With stuff you don't know how to draw, just go ahead. And don't be too worried to fail, yeah. If you worry too much, you don't do it. You don't try, so.
Do you have any tips for developing your own style? Was developing a style natural for you?
Okay, the style for me come from, you know, it's not like copy or the style. Actually, style coming to when you find your own solution for your problem. Style is like it's not like a quality, it's like more like when you have a problem to draw something, you find a solution that become your style. Can you translate for me? I don't explain very well. Actually, when you have a problem, you try to find a good. The style is a solution you found for yourself, right? To fix your problem. That's the style I think coming from. Is this enough clear or?
Yeah, it's clear to me. They're saying, thank you for answering my question. Yes, Nicholas does have Instagram. She said, that's the most helpful advice I've heard about style. Thank you, Nicholas.
Good. Because for example, for me, it takes a long time to accept my own style, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was feeling it's like too weird. And it's more like, it was more like a complex than, beginning I didn't like at all my style.
Mm-hmm.
But it was like, it's weird. And little by little, I learned to accept it. And,
Another question, how did you practice to have such a bold line work?
The line?
Okay. Yeah, bold, like confident line work.
Actually, it's not confident line work. It's like walking on the line and you know on the court. And every time I stop, I lose my my flow. So, you know, it's like, how you say, walking on the court like this. And there's many mistakes, and I try to go back. It's like balance.
Mm-hmm.
And yes.
So for you, it's not about line quality, it's more like expressing.
Yeah. Not easy. So, yeah, it's like, funambulisme. Funambulism. I don't know English. And you know when people are in the circus, they walk between very tight. My cat want to go in again.
What is something you have recently learned about art that you wish to know, that you wish you knew earlier?
The drawing on the many details on a big, big piece of paper. I should have done this before.
So working big.
Yeah, not make a bigger drawing, but make many, many drawings on the big one. Being one piece of paper, I should have tried before. I think I was a lack of confidence too long time, and it, actually I enjoyed it.
Do you only use one brush?
Yeah. And the most destroyer I can. I'll show you. Like this have many possibilities. Can be fat. No need to change. And I don't like when it's too clean.
Mm-hmm. To like the felt tip, you want it to be worn down a bit.
And after you see, I come back on my drawing many times with white. And sometimes it was better before, but I don't care. I just try another way. Before my coworker, we are so scary. Why I delete, redo again?
How do you strike a balance between expressiveness and detail?
That's funny. All the question is like I think about, but actually is about I feel right or not. Sometimes I put too much detail. I wish I put less. And my drawing is kind of too abstract, so I never know before what it's gonna be. So I don't know, depend. And I use this kind of white.
Yeah, white out?
Yeah, because it dries very quick. If I use the comics one, it's too slow.
Is your style inspired by Asian ink style?
I start by anything I saw. Like in my home, there's many things from Asia, like ceramic and everything when I was kid, and book. But I like also painting book, like I told yesterday, Goya. And I don't know, when I was in high school, I think. I start to read the manga also, like Akira. Before I was more inspired by South of America, like stuff like Maya or Mexico. I was very curious when I was a kid, so I tried it anyway. Was like telling myself story. So, of course, now it's a long time in Asia. So,
who are your favorite French artists?
As a comic artist.
Any French artist.
Like this, really loved Mobius before. Mobius, Rochette, like Blood, like De Crécy also, Nicolas De Crécy, like this, I don't know. Hard time to draw and talk at the same time. So
it's okay. They're saying, I love your art style, Nicholas.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoy it.
Is there anything you are afraid to draw or paint?
I'm afraid to draw?
Yeah, is there anything that you are afraid to draw?
There's thing I don't like to draw, like I don't like too much to draw horse.
House?
Horse.
Horse.
Yeah, I really don't really like to a house.
Oh.
I didn't like to a car, but I enjoy now. I'm scared to do a question. Nobody afraid, just I like, or I don't like, or I don't feel it. But, depend of moment. I'm afraid to draw on public, that's true, but not a topic. There's no topic before I know.
Great, so we have about 5 minutes to go.
5 minutes? Oh, my. Sorry. Okay. I want to add something. I'm fine, too quick.
We have about 4 minutes, Nick.
Okay, I'm almost done.
I can tell. Yes, Nicholas does have a cat. Where did you put your cat today?
He's outside.
He's out.
He's not, yeah. He's shaved. Attention. Yesterday he was a mess. Because he can't open the door. I have to block the door.
He can't open the door.
He's too messy guy. He's a Bengal cat, so he's very playful. He's like a dog, actually. Here we go. Can you see it?
Yes, we can see it. I think you have to zoom out just a little bit.
Yeah, I tried. Because I think I zoom out to maximum.
Oh, it's okay. We can see it really great. Thank you so much, Nick.
That's it.
Thank you so much, Nick. Do you want to switch back to your camera?
Yeah.
So we can say goodbye.
Hi again.
Thank you so much, Nick. So please be sure to upload your drawing on your Instagram so we can take a look of detail view. And are you joining 7:30 Art Jam?
Okay, yes, sure.
Okay, so he'll be joining 7:30 Art Jam. And thank you so much, Nick. I'll see you soon.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye. Jeonggi 선생님, 제 말 들리세요?
예, 잘 들립니다.
안녕하세요.
안 들리는데.
안 들려요?
여기 소리 열어주세요.
여보세요?
네, 저는 들리는데요.
나는...
들립니다.
들리신가요?
이상한데, 열릴 것 같은 의미가 아닌 것 같은데.
저 핸드폰으로 들려야죠. 자꾸 붙어있어.
김 정기 is getting ready. I'm sure.
Yes, 됐습니다.
잘 들립니다.
와, 소리 엄청 크네.
정기 선생님, 안녕하세요.
예. 안녕하십니까.
Hello, everyone. So we have Kim Jeong-gi here. And we have amazing artist Boeing who's going to translate for Kim Jeong-gi's 30-minute live drawing. So we have received many, many private commissions. So he will be doing one of the letter size with a singular character. And the theme was wizard. So whoever commissioned this yesterday, today is your lucky day because you get to witness it in person. So we're going to switch the camera to his canvas so you guys can start seeing his drawing. 자, 카메라 바꿔주세요.
예, 30분 만에 이거 그릴 수 있나?
보이 씨 목소리가 조금... 제가 정기 선생님을 끄고
네, 지금 열었습니다.
오케이.
오케이. 됐죠?
네.
네, 머리 많이
자, 커미션이 오랜만에 해보네 하면요.
It has been a while since he did a commission.
아 진짜 여러분 커미션을 안 주셔서
네?
예, 여러분들이 커미션을 안 주셔서 정말 힘들게 살고 있어요.
It has been a while since he did a commission because it's because of you guys who never commanded any commission to Zhongbi. So he has been living a hard life because he wasn't gaining enough money.
예, 많이 좀 지원해 주십시오.
Please send in commands.
네.
And Misu just whispered liar behind his back. He's very rich, as Jesus said behind his back.
지수 같은 애들은 안 돼요.
And Zhongbi said, Miss Jisoo is not 안 된다는 게 뭐죠? 어떻게 안 되죠?
지수 커미션 제가 하겠습니다.
Zhongbi just promised you guys that he will be doing all the commission works that Miss Jisoo received.
예, 저는 부잣집 딸이라서 드렸어요.
Miss Jisoo doesn't have to work because she comes from a very wealthy family.
이렇게 루머를.
Of course, it's a rumor. I hope you guys all, you know the drill.
예. 재광이 많이 도와주십시오.
Please help 재광 get richer. Please request him some commissions. 선미님이 금수지수래요. Zhongbi's gotta buy his Ferrari. 정기쌤 페라리 사셔야죠.
예, 맞습니다.
Yeah, true. He has to buy his Ferrari.
제가 어저께 말했죠.
But he said yesterday.
제가 그리면 다 이루어져요.
He told you guys yesterday. Whatever he draws, he gets.
비자드.
Only give you commission if you tell us what pen you use. 샘이 펜 못 쓰는지 알려줘야지 커미션 요청하겠다고 합니다.
아, 이 사람들이 또 도발하네.
Stop irritating Zhongbi, please.
예?
Zhongbi said.
오늘 기분 좋게 시작하려고 했는데.
He was starting, you know, this piece very nicely in a good mood, and you kind of ruined. You kind of ruined everything. He now wants to stop.
저는 펜텔 브러쉬 펜을 사용하고 있습니다.
There you go. Pentel brush pen. So he'll be waiting for your request for commissions soon.
근데 여러분 이걸 쓴다고 저처럼 그려지는 건 아니에요. 그래서 사실 때 김정기 버전 펜텔 사셔야 됩니다.
And don't forget when you are going to purchase the Pentel brush pen, please don't forget to buy the Kim Jong-gi version of it.
차이가 뭐죠?
What's the difference? 차이, difference?
저희의 개기름이 묻어 있어요.
The Pentel, the Kim Jong-gi version Pentel brush pen comes along with the sweat of Kim Jong-gi.
예, 딱 줬을 때 여기가 끈적끈적해야 돼.
You'll feel how sticky it is as soon as you grab the pen.
예, 그게 제 겁니다.
That would be the Kim Jong-gi edition. That would be the Pentel brush pen edition Kim Jong-gi. 떡볶이가 좋습니까? 어묵이 좋습니까?
그런 서민 음식 좀 먹지 않습니다.
떡볶이 and fish cake in South Korea are sometimes considered as a food for people that don't have money. And Zhongbi said that he doesn't eat those 네. because of the reason that you know now.
저는 러시아산 캐비어 좋아합니다.
He prefers the caviar from Russia.
예. 떡볶이 그거 나 이때까지 안 먹었던 것 같은데.
He never had tteokbokki before. When did Kim Jong-gi lose his hair? He is not bald, but he shaved his head.
(웃음) 지금 쓰고 있는 종이가 저희 현진쌤 역시 좋아하는 종이.
The paper that he is using is 비싼 거죠.
야, 저는 별로 좋아하지 않는데.
So the paper, it's Hyunjin Kim who chose a paper for Jeonggi. It's one of his favorites, and it's not one of his. It's not one of Jeonggi's favorite.
그래서 되게 깨끗해요 종이가.
So it's very, very. How do we call it? Very clean and flat the paper.
그래서 현진 쌤이 제가 후반 작업이나 책 작업할 되게 편하다고 이 종이를 쓰라 그러는데 절대 안 쓰지는.
And Hyunjin prefers this paper. Hyunjin wants Jeonggi to draw on this paper because it makes the bookmaking process a whole lot easier when editing. So Hyunjin always recommends this paper to Jeonggi, and that's why Jeonggi never uses it. Jeonggi is a bully. Does Kim Jeonggi think that artists should draw without sketching even if they are young? If I may, since he's working on his commission, he always says that sketching with a pencil is very important. When he was young, he would like put a lots and lots and lots of details into his sketches. He would always do a pencil sketch before inking. So this is a small revenge from Hyunjin Kim showing his head. Shiny, shiny head.
Shiny?
Shiny? He's not bald. This paper is a bit slippery. It's too neat. No texture at all.
제가 별로 안 좋아하는 책은 제가.
So that's why Jeonggi doesn't really, you know, like this paper. 현미님이 목은 쏴라 있네.
예. 여러분들이 뭐 제가 그림 실력을 얻고 머리카락을 잃었다라고 말씀하시는 분들 계신. 저 대머리 아니고요.
정기
그냥 깎는 거예요.
Jeonggi would like to emphasize on the fact again. He's not bald. He shaves his head. Sometimes people joke about like him losing hair because he got the power of drawing. It's not true. He shaves his head. What is the most fun thing to draw in your opinion? 선생님 의견, 그리기 제일 재밌는 것은 무엇입니까?
저는 여자 그리는 거 좋아해요.
Girls, women.
예. 왜냐면은
Because
젊었을 때 연애를 많이 못 그거의 보상 심리로
Because he never dated enough when he was young. So it's kind of a compensation mentality.
저희 모든 상상력을 발휘해서
So he puts all of his imagination into his drawings when drawing women.
그때 못 해봤던 것들을 그림으로 풀고 있어.
He is doing everything that he wished for. He is drawing everything that he imagined.
이런 게 범죄가 아니잖아요.
Because you know, it's not a crime. It's not a crime. So it's very you know, it's legal. Because it's just a drawing, and he is, you know, freeing all his imaginations and urges into the paper, onto the paper.
근데 아까도 말했듯이 제가 그리는 거는 다 이루어졌었거든요.
But at the same time, as he said, as he told you guys yesterday, everything he 근데, has drawn has become the reality.
근데 여자는 안 되네.
But apparently, the woman part never became true, never became a reality for him.
그림 신에게 더 필요해 될 것 같아.
He has to pray more to the God of drawing. 가끔 통역하는 분한테 자기가 미안하네요. No, I'm having fun. I'm having fun. He's a nice person. He's a nice person with a sense of humor that is a bit exquisite, but he's a nice person and I enjoy working with him. So now we know what pen you use. Can we know what razor you use? 이제 쌤 무슨 펜 쓴지 알았으니까 그 머리 깎는 거 기계 못 쓴지 알 수 있습니다.
제가 좀 그거는 나중에
later 제가 on. 좀 I'll share the information later on. Yes, and he is married and he has two kids.
좋은 거 썼는데.
Please ask 그 정기 if he will ever make a sequel to Omen Follows. 온팔로스 같은 책 하나 더 내실 건지 여쭤본다고 합니다.
여러분 그런 책 좋아하세요?
Everyone, do you guys actually like Follows?
제가 이제 애들이 이제 고등학생 중학생 그래가지고 학교에서 물어볼 것 같아요. 니네 아빠가 그린 거야?
His kids has grown up. The oldest one is now going to enter high school. And the youngest one into middle school, and he is a bit afraid that their friends, their colleagues, their friends might ask, you know, did your father drew this? Did your father draw this? He's afraid that.
그래도 상관없어.
His kids will get this question, but at the same time, he doesn't even care.
내야죠.
So he's going to make a sequel to Follows. 마이 페이버 정기 북 제일 좋아하는 거래요.
맞습니다. 비싼 종이 책이 저기 왜 발음이 안 돼요? 비싼 책이 좋은 책입니다.
Well, yeah, he likes and follows too because it's the most expensive one. Will you come back to Comic Con San Diego after COVID is over? It was transcendent. 혹시 이제 코비드 코로나 끝나고 샌프란시스코 코믹콘도 다시 오실 것입니까? 너무 좋았는데.
예, 미국 매니저한테 물어보죠.
Yes, of course. Let's ask him. Yes, she's saying yes. Yes. Do you enjoy drawing city? Do you enjoy drawing cities or do they get too repetitive for your taste? 도시 같은 거 그리는 것도 좋아하세요? 아니면 너무 반복적인가요?
아니요, 좋아합니다.
He likes it. But it's true that he doesn't really like doing repetitive things like windows on a building.
네, 도시 그리는 거 많이 그렸었는데.
He drew a lot of cities.
해외 여행 가면은 많이 그렸었.
He drew a lot of cities when he was traveling.
네, 요즘에는 뭐 나갈 일이 없어서.
But, but nowadays, since he is staying only in South Korea, he doesn't draw that much. Thank you. What's your advice to someone who wants to draw like you, especially in the sense of detail, method, and style? 쌤처럼 뭐 디테일 그리고 스타일 방식에 있어서 쌤처럼 그리려면 뭘 해야 할까요?
우선은 많이 그려야 되게.
You have to draw a lot.
그 다음에 관찰을 많이 해야 돼요.
And he says this every single time, but you have to do a lot of observation. And if I may add, he said that how the way he approached into observation and drawing wasn't like as if he drew what he was seeing, but he drew what he saw.
그 다음에는 뭐 음영이죠, 이제.
And then it's so you draw a lot, you do a lot of observation, and then what you do is you adapt. You place, you use what you've observed into your drawings.
So 내가 제가 하는 거는 보고 그리는 게 아니라 보고 본 걸 그리는 거.
Exactly. Jeong-gi just said it again. Jeong-gi said that what he does is not. He is not like as if he draws what he sees, what he observes, but he draws what he has observed, what he saw.
그래서 어떻게 보면 어릴 때부터 그림 그리는 방식이 다른 분들하고 좀 달랐을 수도 있어.
So he thinks that the way he drew things might have differed from the ways of other people's approach of drawing.
그래서 내가 평소에 보았던 것들, 관심 있는 것들, 그런 것들을 계속 관찰해서 이미지화 시킨 다음에 거기에다가 제 상상력을 플러스 시켰어요.
So what he did is that he paid constant attention to all the things that interested in him, and then he would visualize all these things that he observed inside his head, and then he would add his imagination into it and then draw it.
그런 훈련, 그런 훈련 방식이라든지 그 다음에 접근하는 방식이 좀 다른 방식이었던 것 같아.
So he thinks that he had a different way of approaching to the drawing, and he used a different technique to observe things. So that might have been different. That might be the thing which made the difference between him and other people.
보통은 보고 그리는 것에 익숙하지 않습니까?
Because we are very used to draw what we see in front of our eyes.
아니 그런데 어릴 때 보면은 우리 보고 그리는 것보다는 자기 상상으로 많이 그리지 않습니까?
But when we are a kid, if we think back, when we are kids, we draw from imagination.
그래서 어릴 때 그리는 방식에서 못 벗어났다고 생각하십니까?
So simply put, Jeong-gi never graduated from his younger days. He just like he continued drawing from his imagination. He never grew up. We could also put it like that.
예, 어릴 때 머물러 있다고 생각하나?
His mindset is still back in his early days. We'll say that.
그래서 저는 저번에도 말했는 것처럼 그릴 때 언제 어릴 때 기분으로 그리려 그래요.
He said this before, but every single time when he draws, he tries to draw like a kid, like as if he was a kid.
어릴 때부터 한 거 그렸나?
Did he draw like naughty things since he was little? Does that mean that?
Point. Did we ever go over the question from GN? Thank you, GN. Does Super any offer beginner tutorials? Did we go over this question?
Super any offers
beginner tutorials?
Because 그 슈퍼애니에서요 그 네. 초심자들한테 튜토리얼도 제공하나요?
아니요 아직 그런 건 없고요.
Not really for the moment.
지금 제가 하는 거는 중국 쪽에서 이제 수업 같은 걸 하고 있습니다.
Although
온라인 수업.
It's not a tutorial that he's giving, but he's giving lectures to Chinese students in a Chinese platform these days.
그래서 미국 쪽에서도 이제 아마 영상이라든지 이런 것들로 많이 찾아뵐 수 있을 거.
But he thinks that he will be able to reach you guys with some more videos, lectures. Kazun Art 통해서죠. Via Kazun Art for the people in the States and for the people who speak English.
Just for the information, Kim Jeong-gi does have his lecture that focuses in character design and people and perspective in kazunonline.com. Kim Jeong-gi's course is not for super beginner, but then we do have a beginner course by Hyunjin that goes over human anatomy. Yeah,
But yeah, feel free to check them out. There are some free video that highlights the summary of the lecture. But unfortunately, Kim Jung-gi's course, you would need to have some foundational level understanding of human anatomy and somewhat basic perspective, which is visual communication in this case.
허립 씨가 지금 홍보했습니다. 돈 벌려고.
웃으시는데요. 아니라고 하셨습니다.
아니랍니다. 예, 어림 씨는 지금 오랫동안 학생들을 가르치는 일에서 정말 좋은 선생이에요. 제가 나쁜 선생이에요.
Jung-gi is saying that Lim Her, the manager of Kim Jung-gi in the States and the founder of Kazun Arts, if I'm correct. Anyways, she's a great teacher and she has been inspiring a lot of students, unlike Jung-gi, he said. Right, Hyunjin? Am I a bad professor? And Hyunjin shouted out, yes.
Yeah, 그쵸, 재강아.
Yeah. And he also asked. He also asked Jaegwang if he's a bad teacher, and Jaegwang also shouted out, yes.
Yeah, 애들이 요즘 헬렐레 하네요.
Well, kids these days, yeah, Jung-gi said.
지금 시간이 어느 정도 남았나?
아까 지금 어떤 댓글에서
We have about 6 minutes.
6분 남았습니다.
6분 남았어요? 6분 동안 어떻게 그려?
'd you recommend someone to approach learning anatomy from the Stonehouse's anatomy book? 그 흑정 작가님 아나토미
네.
해부학 책을 가지고 어떻게
네.
해부학을 공부하면 좋을지 방향성을 제시해 주실 수 있을까요?
그 책에 보면은요 다른 해부학 책들하고 달리 이제 그림을 그린 사람이 만들었기 때문에 우리가 잘 이렇게 좀 간지러운 부분들, 좀 긁고 싶은 부분들에 대한 궁금증이라든지 이런 거에 대한 표현이 잘 되어 있습니다. 그러니까 우선은 한번 처음부터 끝까지 한번 쭉 읽어보시는 게 좋아요.
He would recommend you to read the book entirely from the beginning until the end. Unlike other anatomy books, Stonehouse's anatomy note is written by a artist himself. So he shares all the same difficulties that the people who draw share. So he will be a great help to resolve all these, you know, all these stress, all these questions that you have regarding the anatomy. So he recommends to read the book entirely first.
그런 다음에 이제 필요한 파트들 아니면 처음부터 쭉 따라 그려보셔도 괜찮을 것 같습니다.
And he would also recommend to copy all the drawings, all the tutorials from the beginning till the end. And after you've done that, he would like to recommend to concentrate on few chapters that you think that you need to improve on your drawing.
Yeah. 저도 인체를 잘 몰라.
Jung-gi said that him too. Jung-gi too. He doesn't really understand anatomy. He doesn't know entirely.
그래서 석가 책이라든지 뭐 다른 해부학 책 같은 것들 한 번씩 봅니다. 저도.
So he also looks. He also reads, sometimes look at the anatomy related books, including Stonehouse's anatomy note.
근데 but, 도움이 많이 되는 것 같습니다.
And Zhonggi thinks that it really helps. Yeah. It helps him a lot. Does he drink a lot of coffee? 커피 많이 드시나요?
네, 원래 커피 안 먹었었는데.
He never drank coffee before. But
콜라를 못 먹게 된 후로.
He drank a lot of Coke, but ever since he got his diabetes and he stopped drinking Coca-Cola, he started to drink more coffee.
예, 커피를 좀 잘 먹습니다.
Yeah, he likes drinking coffee. Oh. What month will the new Kim Jong-gi course become available on Kazoom?
I think that's a question for me. We are working, basically what we are doing this time is with restricted traveling, we decided to translate and re-edit his live drawing course that he's doing with school in China. So we are editing and we are almost done with the phase one. So it will be released very soon, which is, we're thinking about 2 months. So yeah, it will be a really great course. I love the contents and we have many more episodes and many more sessions coming up. So if you guys are subscribed to this channel and to Kim Jong-gi US Instagram and Kazon Art Instagram, you guys will be the first one to know.
Why does Kim Jong-gi like Norman Rockwell so much and has he read this book? 왜 노만 로겔을 그렇게 좋아하시는지?
네? 어떤 걸?
노만 로겔.
아, 노만 로겔.
책 읽어보셨는지.
제가 뭐 다른 그림들은 그냥 한 번 보고는 끝이었어요, 웬만하면.
He really likes Norman Rockwell and he has read his book. And other than other artists, other art books, he has read several times the book of Norman Rockwell. 네.
그리고 비구상계열 그림은 나하고 입맛이 완전 안 맞기 때문에 관심도 없었고요.
And the art book, the artist, the drawing of the artist, which are similar to drawings of Zhonggi, he's not really interested.
그러다가 노만 로겔 그림은 계속 뜯어보면 뜯어볼수록 뜯어볼 구석들이 많아.
But Norman Rockwell's drawings, the more and more you look into it, there are so many things that you learn from it.
그리고 그 표정이라든지 포즈라든지
the pose, the face expression of the people inside his paintings.
그다음 그는 그 구도 같은 것들
and the
composition.
Yes, and the composition.
그래서 정말 배울 게 많았어.
So many things to learn from the artist.
네, 이제 시간 다 됐습니다.
예, 한때는 계속 들고 다녔었어요.
He used to carry his book all the time. Because he needed to constantly study his paintings. Norman Rockwell.
Done.
30분 만에 못 그리네.
자, 화면 공유 넘기겠습니다.
예.
수고하셨습니다.
수고하셨습니다.
Alan, thank you. We're going to answer your question in the different live stream. We are disconnecting this live stream and joining back on. We'll be right back. Thank you.